So one of the features of the Cooke family cottage, of course, is NetZero, which means we've got solar, 10 kilowatt solar array, and I think that went up about 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, it did, and actually I got a call from Will at Blue Water Energy, and we're actually connected right now, so the construction is being solar powered right now.
Really? That's cool. All your tools and stuff, all the plug-ins.
Yeah.
I remember last time when we built the cottage during winter, there was electric heat going on, and the bills were actually pretty extensive.
They can be, yeah.
And so now we're getting rebates and all that.
That's right.
Well, that's kind of cool. That's got to get us some green points.
Yeah, I would think.
Yeah. So but we had a couple little glitches because of the steel roof. Just help me understand what went on there.
We had to add some backing in the trusses just because of where their rib and the steel landed. They needed to land the bracket for the solar on the flat part of the steel roof. So we had to add a few 2x6 pieces of blocking in, which wasn't too big a deal. And then they were able to mount their brackets and put the solar panels on.
So it wasn't really a structural issue, because
no.
We'd sorted that out before.
Yeah, we sized the trusses to carry a little bit more weight, to carry the weight of the solar, so that was sorted out in the engineering phase.
So just a little bit of back framing.
Yep.
And then, of course, the guys ran. How did that sort out between the electricians and the solar guys in terms of who ran the conduit and the electrical connections?
Solar guys ran all the conduits back to the panel, and then the electricians hooked everything up at the panel.
Hey, in this segment, I just wanted to take a quick second to highlight the combiner panel for the solar product. The solar that we have on the roof here at the Cooke Family Cottage is a microinverter, and it actually has three power feeds that come down into this panel. It gangs it all together, ultimately sends it out to the grid. I just thought it'd be cool to show, you know, from a solar integration, you really don't see much. You see the roof, and then this is all really that you're seeing inside. This is actually going to hook up to our Tesla power wall as well, which we'll show in future segments. But I just want to give you a sense of how simple this sits next to the main electrical panel. Pretty simple system from a solar perspective. I'm really, really trying to say to you that solar is not that difficult. You're going to be able to integrate it quickly into your projects. I was pretty pleased the way that worked. I think you mentioned Will at Blue Water. He's just such a great guy, and it's something I'd recommend. Find yourself a good, I call it solar integrator. And a nice little meeting between Josh and Will, Josh the electrician, just to make sure that would go smoothly.
Yeah, it went really well.
And so it's something that I always like to highlight. Don't be scared of solar. Find the right folks. You're gonna see a shot of it on the drone, and it looks pretty attractive.
It does. It's amazing.
And you can't really see it from the street. Relatively low slope.
Yeah, no, you can't really see it from anywhere other than the neighbor's house.
But already generating that 10 kilowatts. It's kind of cool.
Yeah, it's great.
Let's move on.
Great.